Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. Stop retyping prompts. There will be stuff that you do with ChatGPT, with Gemini, etc. that you do all the time, and you constantly having to go back and find your prompts, etc. Well, today we're jumping into Gemini and we're jumping into Gems. I'm going to show you three ways where I use Gems to upgrade my YouTube thumbnails really easily, to act as a leadership council for me, and to create social media posts. I'll show you how I set them up. I'll give you all the prompts, etc. Let's dive in. So what are Gems? They are custom helpers. They're like custom GPTs in both ChatGPT and in Copilot, but these work with inside Gemini. Gemini got this great new model out with Gemini 3. You can use Nano Banana Pro with them, really powerful. Let's get in and have a look. So if you go onto Gemini and you go over to Gems, you can click on Gems. And first of all, you've got some pre-made Gems by Google. And you can have a look at these. So they've got a coding partner, copy creator, storybook, Women's World Cup. Make Gemini your companion for the ICC Women's Cricket World Cup. Experimental, learning coach, outreach specialist, sales pitch ideator. Really, really very cool. And then you can make your own Gems. And I've got three Gems I've made: a social promo generator, a leadership council, and a thumbnail builder. And I'm going to go through how I built each of those and we'll test them and you can have a look at them. And remember, you can download all of the system prompts, all of the knowledge documents that I've added in. I'll put them all in a folder on the website. There'll be a link down below and you can take them, change them, make them your own and use them with Gemini. Let's move on. So I've got a work account, but Gemini Gems are available on the free version. There you can create custom Gems, you can use the pre-made Gems and you can access them on mobile and web. There might be some limitations in terms of context window for free users, on the platform that it's using, and on the model power that you've got access to. But these, you can do this for free today. Just follow along with me. Let's jump in and create our first Gem. So first of all, you go over to Gems, and I showed you the Gems made by Google, and then you can say add a new Gem. Very straightforward this. So first of all, you give your Gem a name, then you give it a description, so saying what it does, and then you give it some instructions, and it gives you an example of the instructions, and then you can load up knowledge, and you get a preview on this side. It's very straightforward. So have a go. Try it. You can delete them afterwards, no problem. Let's jump into the ones that I've done and show you how they work. I've got three. So first of all, my thumbnail builder Gem. Here we are in the thumbnail builder and let's edit the Gem so we can have a look. So there we go. I've called it thumbnail builder. This Gem will take thumbnails I've created in Canva and make them unskippable, which is what I want it to do. And so we have a series of instructions. And as I say, I will pop these instructions down below, but I might want several things from this thumbnail builder. First of all, I might want to create a thumbnail just from an idea, and it will do that. But also, I have set up a set of instructions for a beginner, intermediate, and advanced thumbnail. So what I'm going to do is go back through my thumbnails and change them so that they're easier to pick out. So if you're looking for a beginner's advice on something, then all the thumbnails will have a similar look to them, and then intermediate and then advanced, to make it easy for you to find the videos you want. Now, I received this as some feedback from VidIQ. Great guys, let's have a look. So here we are on X, and I got this lovely request: drop your YouTube channel below and I'll tell you one thing you can improve on. I'll be replying all day. Follow these guys at VidIQ. If you are a content creator, this service is great. So I dropped my channel. Let's find it here. There we go. I put my channel in and I got this wonderful reply. Here are a few things to test with your packaging right now. Add visual variety to thumbnails. Shoot some new reaction poses. I'm going to be doing that soon. Cut your thumbnails down. Rewrite the titles. You could also try visually separating beginner versus advanced videos using different color schemes. Green for beginner, blue for intermediate, black and gold for expert. Got great videos. You've had some great success so far. You make each video stand alone amongst the rest. You're going to be cooking. Thanks for your submission. And I said, thank you so much for your feedback. I really appreciate it. So I got this feedback from VidIQ. So I thought, let me create a gem to give me this response. So this is the description. This is the instructions for this gem. If the user is looking to build or create a beginner, intermediate or advanced thumbnail, then refer to the instructions in the knowledge. Otherwise, use the instructions below. And then always use Nano Banana Pro to produce the images. And then transform the upload. The uploaded thumbnail into a hyper-engaging professional-grade visual that maximizes click-through rates. I won't go through all of this, but I'll put all of this in the pack. Just go to the link below and you can draw it all down. And then in the knowledge area, I've created this prompt details doc. Here we go. List of specific styles for beginner, intermediate, and advanced style. And again, beginner, intermediate, and expert. I've dropped that in. Let's lock that off. And let's have a look at the thumbnail builder. So here we go. Let's open it up. Okay, so what I did was I dropped in this thumbnail of a Copilot tutorial that I did a few weeks ago. And I said, upgrade this using the beginner profile. And it went through some thinking, very cool. And then it produced me the beginner profile with the green around it. So if I go through all my current thumbnails that are beginners and then put it through this, then it will produce this sort of green effect. Then I said, give me the intermediate one, and it gave me this. I'm not sure I'm overly happy with this text, but it gives me this. And then I said, give me the advanced version, and it gave me this one. I have to look a bit serious in this one. But we've got this black and gold for the advanced version. How cool is that? And I can just take my thumbnails, drop them in and make these changes and then upload them to YouTube. Really cool. Let's move on to my leadership council. Here we go. Once again, this is what my gem looks like. And once again, you can get all of the information you need in the link below. So the leadership council, council of leaders to discuss issues, decisions, etc. And I have a whole series of instructions here. So you're a leadership council, giving it a persona, a panel that reviews ideas from six roles. So I've got a CFO, COO, a CHRO, looking at people, general counsel, contracts, privacy, etc., compliance, CMO, positioning, audience and channels, and a critical friend, looks at assumptions, blind spots, second order effects. And when the user submits an idea, replay this format, give a summary, key assumptions, panel feedback. Each persona gives three bullets, one concern, one suggestion, one question. Where the panel disagrees, give us bullets, recommendations, next five actions, metrics. And the rules, be direct. The idea is vague. Ask up to three questions to give a provisional review and don't write long essays. Can't be doing with that. And then we've got some knowledge. So I put in some leadership personas and red flags. So who the CFO is, who the COO is, CHRO, what they care about, their red flags, good signs, what they like, and all the way through that. You can change this for you, of course. You can add in extra personas. You can take out personas. You can change what's important to them. Here's a model for you to use. And then some instructions around decisions to make, look at goal for 30 days, target users, what changed in their day, benefits, costs, risks, safeguards, success metrics, owner, next actions. Just a template of how to make a decision, and that's it. So all of that's available. You can go and have a look. You can change it. I've built these for demonstration purposes. Let's go and have a look at the leadership council. So what I did was say that I was suggesting, my idea was to build a paid course called Gems for Executives. So me building gems for you, priced at £99. I was going to put it out on my YouTube channel and on theprofessor.info, 200 sales in 60 days, review as a full panel, then give me the next actions. And it gave me a summary of the idea, key assumptions, and then I got the panel feedback. So the CFO was concerned at the price point, not surprising, and gave me suggestions and asked some questions. COO, concerned about manual steps everywhere. A lot of it was manual. Suggestion, implement a simple operating model. So think about how people might ask for them, how we might produce them, how we might get them back to them. And then concerns, people will just adapt. Is it red flag? Who's going to maintain this program, etc. General counsel was worried about IP risks. Are we selling proprietary company secrets or a general methodology? And concerns, everyone is my audience. 99 price point signals entry level to a C-suite buyer, causing a brand mismatch. So setting it up for executives but charging £99 is a mismatch. Good point. And then the critical friend, big claims without a baseline, aiming for 200 sales in 60 days implies very high conversion rate. Set some stop criteria. If you don't sell 10 units in the first week, then stop. Second order effects is your reputation. If it's perceived as cheap, price positioning, automated system, very, very cool. Metrics to suggest in 30 days. And then it said, would you like me to draft a pre-sales landing page copy to address the CMO's concern? So really very cool. This doesn't take a long time to get an answer back. It doesn't take 10 minutes or anything like that. Within a few minutes, you get a response. And it's a great way of spitballing ideas, thinking them through before you take them to the real humans, I guess. All right, let's move on. The final gem I produced was a social promo generator. And this produces promotional artifacts for the professor.info and my YouTube channel. And I have got your social promo generator for a UK business audience, inputs you may receive, video title, 3 to 6 points, target audience, CTA, tone notes, any claims that need care. And then you need to put out a LinkedIn post, produce a LinkedIn post, Facebook post, an X post. User mentions an image, write alt text, and rules, British English, no hype, no exaggerated claims. If the user includes numbers or results, ask for its source, if not provided. And if the user gives no CTA, suggest one soft CTA and one stronger CTA. So that's what I produced. Let's have a look at it. So what I did was put in this video that you're watching now, build a thumbnail coach gem, a leadership council gem and a social promo gem, audience, busy professionals and execs, that's you, and CTA, subscribe and grab the templates. Here's the social media prompts, LinkedIn post, stop writing the same prompts for each from scratch, and then it gives me a LinkedIn post for that and pushes people to download the templates. You're very welcome, for all free. Facebook post, are you manually rewriting context every time, and an X post and some alt text for the video. Very, very cool. So that's it. Gems, really powerful tools. They're actually quite simple to make. There's only about 4 or 5 boxes to fill out, and then you've got a tool that you can use over and over again. The real key is to iterate your instructions, whether it's the direct instructions or whether it's the knowledge you're giving the gems. Do that and you'll have a tool you can keep going back to again and again and again. Hope that's been helpful. Don't forget, give me a like, it really helps to get the video out there and get other people to see it. If you've not subscribed, please do. I'm really close to that 10,000 number I'm trying to get to by Christmas. So if you're not subscribed, drop me a subscribe, that'd be really helpful. Share this video with other people you think might be interested, and I'll see you soon. Bye for now.